Hi, everybody, and welcome to another installment of Align's Daily Dose of Advice, our way of bringing you valuable insights and thought leadership from business experts from around the world on various topics that will hopefully help you and your business. My name is Eugene Turk. I'm the Vice President of Business Development at Align. You can learn more about Align at aligntoday.com. My guest today is Margaret Maclay. Margaret is a certified focal point coach and has been a coach and trainer for more than 13 years. During that time, she has worked with hundreds of business owners, leaders, and teams worldwide in various areas, including communication, which is what we are going to be discussing today. Prior to coaching, Margaret also spent 25 years in the apparel industry, holding a variety of global leadership positions. Hi, Margaret. Thanks for joining us. It's a pleasure to have you.
Thanks, Eric. It's great to be here.
It's okay. That's okay.
Sorry.
Margaret, I know that your tagline is communication is everything, and that certainly, those words could not be more true than right now, as we're all getting accustomed to sort of a new normal in terms of business operations and, importantly, business communication. With that sort of as the backdrop, can you sort of tell us what are the types of discussions and conversations that business leaders need to be having with their executive team leaders right now?
Sure. You know, I've been working with a lot of my clients lately talking about exactly this topic, because how much do they share? What do they share? How frequently? Through which medium? And the really important thing is that they're honest and they're sharing the fact that, yeah, this is a difficult time. There are going to be issues that we're going to have to deal with, but we're going to get through this together. And we're going to come up with a game plan. And, you know, there's a big tendency to, you know, just kind of shoot from the hip and start sending out these communications. And I'm really encouraging them, before they actually begin any kind of communication plan, they actually have a plan. So they think through what's relevant to the different people in their businesses that they need to talk to, whether it's the leaders, the staff, the customers, you know, what's the frequency that needs to take place? You know, what's the focus of those different conversations? Because everybody's got different worries that they have right now in this situation. And the leaders and the business owners need to be thinking about who their audience is. Mm-hmm. And then what are the things that are really relevant to each person in the individual role. So that said, thinking about who the audience is and what they need to know and why they need to know it and how frequently they need to hear from the leader is a really, really important, steps to setting up a communication plan.
And then in turn, what should those business and team leaders, what kind of conversations should they be having with their frontline employees and staff people?
Yeah, and the answer is very similar, but, you know, people are really nervous. And so the managers and the team leaders having conversations with their teams and putting them at ease that there is a plan, that we're going to work through this together, that there are, you know, platforms for them to be heard and to be able to express ideas as well as the concerns that they have on their mind, and to be really straightforward about where are we today, where are we trying to get to, what's the plan to get there, how does each one of those individuals play into that role. And if I could, you know, I'm work with a one of my clients is a performing theater art school. And as you would imagine, all of that, everything that happens in that environment is face to face. And so the first conversations we had with the owner of the school was, what is the game plan for getting through this situation that we have at hand now? How does that business need to pivot to continue to service the students who you know, we don't want to interrupt that, want to continue what they're doing. Number one, who needs to be involved? What additional skills need to be, you know, learned very, very quickly? And how does that then impact the staff? And, you know, so what's the plan? And we put together the plan. The next thing we did was bring in the staff who runs the office and have a really open conversation with them about what exactly the game plan was for the school, how the what the impact was going to be on the office staff, the faculty, and ultimately the students. And then what was the execution plan? And then asked, you know, had an open conversation so that everyone was really clear about what their involvement was going to be and how they played into this bigger picture. As you can imagine, a lot of fear around, am I going to lose my job?
Right.
And, you know, those kind of things. And yeah, there's some sacrifices that had to be made and there were some hours being cut back, but sharing with everybody right up front and being completely straightforward about the fact that we're going to have some cutbacks, but we're going to do everything we can to keep you employed and keep you with some revenue so you can pay your bills and you know, get through this. And that then spun to, you know, what does the faculty need to do to operate differently? And, you know, how are they now going to be impacting and contributing to keeping that those student programs going? And then that ultimately led to what's the message that's got to get out to our student body, which is we're still here. Mm-hmm. We're adjusting to have things moving business as usual as much as possible. Yeah, are we going to change the way we teach and, you know, put things online, but you're still going to get the same quality of teaching. We're still going to have the same frequency of classes and all those kind of things. So these conversations are happening a lot every single day in real life.
And sort of to that point, you sort of touched upon it, but what are some of the best ways that leaders should be communicating right now? I mean, should they be sending emails to all their employees and customers and students of the school? Should we be calling everyone? Should we be recording videos and sending them out? You know, right now there certainly is a sea of increased communication. Yeah. We're getting a COVID-19 email from anyone we've ever given our email address to. So what's the best ways to really be communicating with all of our sort of our customers, our staff, our employees, maybe our investors, everyone right now to really sort of share all that messaging?
Well, the answer is all of the above.
Right.
Because, you know, again, it's really thinking about the audience, what's going to be most appropriate to reach whatever that audience is, whether it's a client or a customer, or whether it's a supplier, whether it's a you know, somebody, a staff member, a manager. But I really think that the email communication is really important because it allows you to lay something out, to give steps, something people can keep, they can print, they can be reminded. But, you know, the face-to-face like we are now, where people can actually see each other and interact, that's really important. The little video clips are great, using Zoom or FaceTime or Skype, all of those things, you know, peppered in, as well as, you know, podcasts and webinars and things like that. And I know every day, just like you, I'm getting bombarded with emails and all different things, text messages and little video clips and all those kinds of things. And I think really being able to utilize all the different platforms is important. You know, one of the things that, you know, in those communications that, again, I think are really important is any communication to be, make sure that it's relevant to the audience. Really think about the frequency. Do you want to be sending something every day, once a week, once every 10 days, 2 weeks? It can be overkill or it can be not enough. So you got to really think about the audience. And it's got to be honest. So letting you know, yeah, we're in a tough time, and then a positive spin, but keep it realistic is important, and have it concise and focused. You know, one of the things that I often see is that somebody will send an email communication, and there's so many different things covered that they all kind of get blurred, right?
Right.
And it's like, oh, which one should I focus on? So I always like to encourage all of my clients, send a message, focus on one specific thing, and really get that across. Then wait a little bit. Now let's get the next thing. So it's a series of communications that are giving these relevant sound bites. And again, that goes back to the communication plan and having a plan rather than just shooting from the hip.
On a more sort of emotional and psychological response, what are some of the benefits, both personally and professionally, that come from having these very open, candid conversations where you're sharing sort of the facts of the business, being very truthful with your employees, and sort of laying out a very realistic picture of what everyone is going through right now?
Well, one of the interesting things is that sometimes it takes a crisis to get people to really come together and communicate effectively and to appreciate each other and to be grateful and to hear the ideas. You know, we get so bogged down sometimes in the day-to-day of things just running that we sometimes lose sight of the fact that we're all people. And so I think there's a lot of emotional stability that comes from these kind of communications. It allows a leader to express how grateful they are and how much they care about the teams that they have put together. It gives information that puts people at ease and can help eliminate the stress. Even if it's not great news, the uncertainty is what runs around in people's heads. When they don't know what's going on, they start to create these ideas of what if, or what's going to happen. But when they have good information and they have good communication, they know what to expect. And that allows them then to calm down, relax, do their job, move forward, and be able to, you know, sort of look into the future and not get sort of drowning in the ditch of today, what's going on today. So, you know, I think it keeps people connected, but I think it really also puts people at ease knowing what's going on and being able to interact in a really positive way.
That's great advice. Margaret, what is the number one piece of advice that you are giving your coaching clients right now?
Stay healthy. Follow the rules and do what you're supposed to do.
Stay home.
Stay at home. Everything you need to do, you can do from home in some way, shape, or form. But you know what? It's really, all the conversations I have with, you know, my fellow coaches, with all of my clients is, you know, just stay calm, use good judgment, stay connected, but, you know, use good judgment and don't overreact. We're getting bombarded with all kinds of messages right now. And just use your good judgment, do what you know is the right thing to do, have a plan, and keep moving forward.
Sounds great advice. All right, Margaret, always a pleasure seeing you. Thank you for joining us and sharing your thoughts and advice. If you would like to learn more about Margaret, please check out Margaret Maclay, margaretmaclay.focalpointcoaching.com. Again, if you'd like to learn more about Align, you can go to aligntoday.com. And we hope you will join us next time. Till then, thank you so much. And I hope you make it a great day.
Thanks.